So for me, this project has been a puzzle of two parts. Now the first part of the puzzle has been the modern DNA side. As you've just heard, I've been working very closely with Professor Kevin Schur, who has carried out a great deal of research on the genealogy side of things. And I'll start with the paternal lines. Several individuals were kind enough to take part in the project. The analysis of these modern individuals is done, and I have a consensus Y chromosome type, the piece of DNA which is just passed down through the male line, for this side of the analysis. On the maternal side, looking at mitochondrial DNA, as Professor Schur just explained, it was important to establish a second line of descent to confirm the maternal DNA line. Both of these individuals were extremely kind in being willing to take part in this project. It's worth pointing out that in a generation's time, this part of the work wouldn't have been possible. Both of these individuals are the last of their lines, so the timing of this excavation has been very important indeed for the DNA analysis. Indeed, I'm indebted to all of the study participants. Now, the second part of the puzzle was the ancient DNA analysis, and to see if it was even possible to retrieve ancient DNA from the skeletal remains. DNA breaks down over time, and how quickly this happens is very dependent on the burial conditions. So even though the remains appear to be in relatively good condition, I couldn't be certain that I would be able to retrieve DNA from them. So the next question was, could we get a sample of DNA to work with? I'm extremely pleased to tell you that we could. Let me start with the male line data. My work on this side of the ancient DNA is in its very early stages, and it's too early to say if there's a match with the modern male line relatives. However, I can tell you that the DNA confirms Joe's analysis that these are indeed the remains of a male individual. On to the maternal side. Now, the first step here was to see if the DNA sequence from Michael matched that of the second line of descent. Here is the DNA sequence, or part of the DNA sequence, from Michael Ibsen. And this is that of the second lineage. As you can see, they did indeed match one another. So this verified the family tree as set out by Professor Kevin Schur. The next step was to see if the DNA sequence from the skeletal remains matched with these individuals. And I can now tell you, there is a DNA match between the maternal DNA from the descendants of the family of Richard III and the skeletal remains that we found at the Greyfriars dig. In short, the DNA evidence points to these being the remains of Richard III.